We want to divide a decimal by a whole number. Here we have 4.3 divided by 2, and here we have 7.83 divided by 9. Remember, division can be expressed in several ways. To divide a decimal by a whole number, we'll first rewrite this as a long division problem. So we'll have 4.3 divided by 2. And this is a pretty straightforward process when dividing by a whole number. What we need to do is take this decimal point and move it up into our quotient. Once we do this, we can divide as we normally would. We first ask how many 2's there are in 4. That would be 2. 2 times 2 is 4. And now we subtract. That would be 0. And now that we already have our decimal point in our quotient, we can go ahead and ignore it. So we'll just bring down the next digit, which is 3. And now we need to determine how many 2's there are in 3, and that would be 1. 1 times 2 is 2. And we subtract, and that would be 1. But when dividing a decimal by a whole number, we can't use the remainder notation. We have to keep dividing until this decimal either terminates or starts to repeat. So the way we do that is we can add extra zeros here on the end of 4.3. Remember, adding a zero to what would be the hundredths place value is not going to change the value of 4.3. So once we add this digit, we can bring it down and then ask how many 2's are in 10. Well, there are 5 2's in 10. 2 times 5 is 10. And now when we subtract, the difference is 0. So we're done, which means this decimal is terminating and the quotient is 2.15, or 2 in 15 hundredths. Our second example is written in fraction form, but a fraction bar does represent division. So we'll set this up in the same way. We have 7.83 divided by 9. And again, as long as we're dividing by a whole number, we just need to move the decimal point up into our quotient, and then we can divide as we normally would, disregarding the decimal. So we first need to determine how many 9's there would be in 78. And that would be 8, because 8 times 9 is 72. And as long as this difference is less than 9, we know this 8 is correct. So we have 6, and this would be 0. Bring down the next digit, which is 3. And now we ask how many 9's there are in 63. That would be 7. 7 times 9 is 63. This difference is 0. We've used all of the digits, so we're done. So this quotient is equal to 0.87, or 87 hundredths. And often what you'll see textbooks do is put a zero in the ones column. It's not required, but sometimes you'll see it written like this. In the next video, we'll take a look at how we divide a decimal by another decimal.